I've sold out one of my Syfe portfolios. So in this video, I'll go through with you the reason for selling this portfolio and also update my Syfe portfolio for the month of November to give a performance update. Hey guys, welcome back to Honey Money SG, and in this channel, we are all about building financial knowledge, share money saving hacks, and also help you lead a fulfilling quality of life. So again, welcome back to my Syfe portfolio update, and disclaimer again, this video is not sponsored by Syfe, and this is definitely not financial advice because you should devise your own strategy instead of following other people on the internet. So let me take you back to my September update, where I actually had 3 portfolios, Cash Plus, Equity 100 and REIT Plus. Now for Cash Plus in September, it actually registered like a 77 cents gain, while for Equity 100, it registered around $8 of loss, and for REIT Plus, it's my worst performer, whereby it registered around $20 of loss. And after that September portfolio, I actually reflected on the Syfe portfolios and maybe wanted to restructure my portfolio, and that's what I did in October, whereby I did a video here as well, so you can see I actually did drastic actions like reduce my Syfe portfolios up to $1,000. So my Cash Plus, my REIT Plus, and my Equity 100 were all sold out until they had $1,000 left in the portfolio. And then I created this Syfe Select Custom portfolio, whereby you can select any ETFs or any investments that are available in the Syfe platform. Now for myself, I chosen the VWRA, CSPX, and QQQ ETFs, these 3 ETFs, to put in the Syfe Select Custom. And you all should know that referral bonuses in Syfe are very techy and are considered part of your investment returns, which is really wrong, right? So that's why like regularly I have to check my Syfe platforms and then sell out those referral bonuses so that we can make an apples to apples fair comparison. So with that, let me take you through my current Syfe portfolio for the November update. Let's go. Okay folks, welcome to my Syfe dashboard again. I'm sure you are familiar with this dashboard by now, so I won't do any introduction on this, but you all should know that all this portfolio return, this $362 is not my total return. So if I refer people like you as a new customer to Syfe, they give me like a few dollars, right? So that's included in this portfolio return. So please don't see I have $362 of return, think I'm an investing god. I'm not, okay? Because I have some referral bonuses which are wrongly accounted for and added into this portfolio return, which I think is wrong, but Syfe just want to classify this to make you feel really good, right? So nothing much you can do about it. All you have to do is to adjust the own returns to your portfolio. And starting with the dashboard, you can see that I do not have Syfe Cash Plus anymore, and I really sold out of this Syfe Cash Plus. I'll explain my reasons why later. And then you can see I have my Diamond Hands portfolio here, and my Equity 100 still here, my REIT Plus is still here as well. Okay, so you can see this is just a quick snapshot. Let's go into the details and see how is it going, right? So let's start with my Cash Plus portfolio first. Okay, you can see my Honeypot Cash Plus portfolio is now dormant. That means I've withdrawn everything. So from 2.5k, I withdraw everything, and I still make a loss of $2.41 over that few weeks or days, right? And I just explain a little bit on why I don't like to use this kind of cash management strategies anymore, right? So I fully withdrawn this on the 4th of November, even though I created it just 2 months earlier in September. Right, I feel that this kind of cash management strategy portfolio, first off, they have really low returns, right? 1.5%. Now, 1.5% in a year, you are still losing to inflation. Now, inflation from US data, they just recorded like 6% total inflation. For Singapore-wise, I don't know, but I think 1.5%, you definitely cannot cover inflation. So don't waste your time on this kind of cash management strategies. And you know what's the other thing? For this kind of cash management strategies, they actually got risk of losing your capital, and that's what happened to me, right? Even putting money in a few weeks, you can lose money, okay? So I cannot imagine if you put it over the long term, how much were you exposed to the fluctuations of the market? So it's really not as stable as you think it is, even though it's not a lot of money. But I think you shouldn't waste time. If you have a risk of losing your capital, I'd rather you put into more high risk, high return stuff. Like if you put in growth stocks, they can grow at least 10 to 20% in the stable companies, right? Your FANG companies, those are awesome, right? 20% year-on-year growth. And then if you have higher conviction in more of the growth stocks like Tesla or C Limited, right? Those can grow up to 40%, 50% per year. But if you don't like stocks, then you can also hold crypto, right? If you use Holdernaut, you can earn up to 12% annual percentage yield on your Holdernaut crypto lending interest, which you can look at my Holdernaut video over here and see how much have I earned. So there are really a lot of ways you can earn this kind of gains. Instead of putting your money into cash management strategies and waste your time, waste your effort to track, and then sometimes you make loss on your capital as well, which is what happened to me. So I would say don't waste time. And if you really want a no loss, risk-free gain, right, I recommend you to watch my credit card videos. Just take some time to go and learn on how to earn rewards on your credit card, whether in miles or cashback, and use it on your daily spending. Don't overspend on your credit card, just use it on your daily spending. Then you'll earn absolute cashback on it, at least 1.7%, right? This is the base floor you could earn from the UOB Absolute Amex cashback, which is better than your Syfe Cash Plus portfolio already, right? 1.7% versus 1.5%. Yeah, so really don't waste time on that. So with that, let me go on to my other portfolios. I have my Diamond Hands, I have my Equity 100, I have my REIT Plus. Let's start with my Diamond Hands, right? Now, Diamond Hands is the portfolio that I curated like 1 month ago. I actually had a video on this. I talk about these three ETFs that I chose to actually form up my Syfe Select Custom portfolio. So Syfe did not choose this portfolio for me. I created this on the 11th of October. So that's around 1 month now. And the currency of USD is around 1.355 SGD now. So that's the current conversion rate. And today's date is 13th of November. Okay, and let's see how much have I gained. All right, so my invested amount is 2.2K. Time weighted return 7.61%. Absolute return $120, of which $5 is the currency gain. So if we deduct from this, that's around $115. So if we take $115 divided by 2200, right, the percentage gain will be around 5% over this 1 month. And that's really because the US stocks have rallied in October, right? 5% in 1 month, not too bad, right? For an ETF, three ETFs, you know, I have S&P 500, I have QQQ, I have VWRA, okay? For an ETF to rally 5%, that's a lot, okay? Those are not your individual stocks, these are ETFs, and I have three of them, okay? And all three of them has gained over this 1 month, which is really good. October was a really good month for stocks and ETFs, excluding those in China. Yeah, so like I mentioned in my earlier Syfe video, I really want to take matters to my own hands and not rely on Syfe's selection, okay? I'll select and create my own destiny, and that's why I call this Diamond Hands, right? We really need to have the conviction, okay? Holding ETFs is a very low risk thing, but you want to select those ETFs that work in your favor. And for myself, I stress again, I really like S&P 500, I really like QQQ, and I really like VWRA. So I hold these three in equal proportions of 33% each, and that's how it has performed over 1 month. So over the long term, let's see how this one goes. But of course, if you disagree with my selection, you can go and select and put in your own funds like an e-commerce card, right? You go and select those ETF that you want. You don't need to copy me 100% one. Sometimes I'm not correct or so, right? So Syfe Select is really the best portfolio that Syfe can come up for. And the irony is they don't even choose it for you, but they can offer those products that you really like. So Syfe Select Custom, very good. Okay, I love it. Diamond Hands portfolio, I hope you go to the moon one day. Okay, next up, let's look at Equity 100, right? Equity 100, you all know, since my earlier Syfe days in July, I started with Equity 100 as well. But in my previous portfolio, I reduced it to $1,000 because there are some ETFs inside that I don't really like, and I just want to reduce my exposure to Equity 100. Same thing here in October, I actually reduced it to around $1,000, so that $2 is maybe some currency fluctuation. But whatever amounts that is above $1,000, right, will be the absolute gain. So my absolute gain is around $60, right? So $60 over $1,000 invested, that's around 6%. Okay, so slightly better than my Syfe Select Custom. Maybe there are some things that really grow inside, I don't know. But good job, Equity 100, I think you have recovered quite well. And just to prove that those are absolute gains, right, you see there are no bonuses here, no referral bonuses here. So it's really raw gains on the Equity 100. So 6% gain over that 1 month since October, very good. Equity 100, I hope you can continue to do well, even though I don't put in much money for you because of the Clean Shares China ETF. Okay, last one is the one many of you actually signed up Syfe for, the REIT Plus. Let's see how the REIT Plus has performed, right? And also in October, I sold out my REIT Plus portfolio to around $1,000. But the thing about my REIT Plus portfolio is that it is quite complicated because most of my referral bonuses actually go into my REIT Plus. So I have to keep withdrawing funds and sometimes I miss it, you know. And then I think I gained so much money over that few days, man. Cannot be, right? And then I look in my transaction and then I will find this thing called bonus, okay? Referral bonus. That means that every time one of you sign up with Syfe, Syfe will credit me with some referral bonus. So really, I have to keep withdrawing money out of this REIT portfolio just so that it is an apple to apple comparison. And so far, I have been withdrawing quite diligently. So recently, they credited this $10 to me. And there's no fixed date that they credit every month. And some random day, they will just credit and then I miss it. And then I thought, hey, suddenly this REIT Plus portfolio going to the moon. Suddenly so much money. But then when I look at the actual REIT stocks in Singapore market, not doing well. How come suddenly got money? Then it must be the bonus already. And that's why I must do things like this. You see, even on the day that I withdraw, the next day they credit me this bonus. And then I must go and withdraw again. Okay. And I haven't withdraw this one. So I'm going to do it right now to see how you can actually withdraw from your Syfe portfolio. So you go to manage funds. And after that, you click on withdraw funds. Okay. Reason for withdrawal. Okay. There are a lot of reasons, but none of them are good. Okay. I'll just tell you. No returns. I don't like. Okay, I'm going to withdraw. Okay, and you can choose between full withdrawal and partial withdrawal. How much are you going to withdraw? I'm just going to withdraw $10, which is the referral bonuses. And then check that your account number and your account holder's name is correct and make sure that it's withdrawing to the right account. After that, scroll to the bottom and click submit. And then they will ask you for your confirmation. You click confirm and then key in the OTP sent into your mobile phone, which will be here within 3 seconds. And I got it 3574. So withdrawal request received, your funds will be transferred with 2 to 3 business days. So that's about it on how you can withdraw. And they don't work on a Saturday, so really you have to take some processing time during the work days. Coming back to my REIT Plus, so after I withdraw, I should have around 1008, right? Because I took out the $10. So $8 over 1000, that's like 0.8% in 1 month. Okay, not bad, considering that they have been disappointing me over the past few months. At least got gain, not bad already. Don't look at this $225 cumulative return, it's not this. Okay, and don't look at this time weighted return, it's a lie. Yeah, so my REIT Plus, the slowest of all, 0.8%, but now it's finally in the green. I'm happy for this slight gain, but I hope it will last forever, but nothing lasts forever. Alright, so that's just a quick snapshot of how my Syfe portfolios have done. My Diamond Hands portfolio has returned around 5%, not 7%. And then my Equity 100 has returned around 6%. And for my REIT Plus portfolio has returned around 0.8% since October. So that's a 1 month performance for you. And hopefully through my sharing, y'all can learn more about this Syfe custom portfolios, which is really what I recommend instead of choosing their Equity 100 and REIT Plus. But if you don't know, then I think going with the Equity 100 is not a bad idea because it will outperform the REIT Plus over a long term, right? Because US markets and international markets are much stronger than Singapore. So if you enjoyed my sharing, just help me comment a thank you in the comment section below. I'll really appreciate it. And let's get back to the video. Alright, welcome back. So let's discuss the good and bad about Syfe and why you should or you should not use it. Now for Syfe, right, it's very simple for really beginners in the stock market and people who want to start out in their investments, right? Because these people, they may be quite risk averse and afraid to put money in the market. So they try to put in small monies every month instead of like doing a lump sum of maybe say 10k into an ETF ticker like VWRA in Interactive Brokers. So if you're like doing $100, $200 per month dollar cost average into an ETF, more likely than not, the commissions and the foreign currency exchange fees would kill you because of the small transaction volume. So that's where Syfe actually come in to actually cater to these small investors. And at the same time, let's say you want to do weekly DCA, you can actually like DCA every week like what I did, right? And you will not be charged like multiple commission fees for each transaction. So that's where Syfe is really good at. Now the bad thing for Syfe is that when your portfolio gets larger and larger, it means their management fees also get larger and larger, right? As a percentage wise. So that once your portfolio maybe like achieve more than $10,000 of value, you will start to see quite significant charges of management fees paid towards Syfe. And you should know that portfolio returns are not guaranteed investments, but management fee expenses are guaranteed, right? So that will all eat into your returns. But for myself, I'm comfortable to contribute $100 every week dollar cost average into into my Syfe Select Custom portfolio, and it will still remain quite a fairly small sum even after 2 years. And also the other purpose is to just give you a performance review of how your performance would have been if you followed my Syfe investment portfolio with the Syfe Select Custom. Of course, every investment comes with risk, and you must be able to tolerate that risk, whether it's going up or going down. And if you want to sign up for Syfe, remember to use my promo code HoneyMoney key in the promo box when you sign up for your Syfe account. So with all that said, I hope you have gained some value from today's video. Give a video at the like at the bottom, just 1 second of your time, and consider subscribing to my channel for more investing and finance content. Also join us over at our Telegram group where we go through such topics every day. My name is Christopher, this is HoneyMoney SG, steering young adults to financial independence.